Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Rustaholics, to Leon's Garage Adventures, to $1,000 Car Guy, to Do Something Every Day. There, now you can pick which one you want. So, today we're going to take the motor back out. We're going to throw the oil pan on that we pulled yesterday for this thing. And maybe we'll start on wiring it up. We got to see if the motor mounts and everything fit that I got for it too. Pulled them off the big block, but I couldn't exactly test fit them because the engine was too far down. As you can see, the last guy thought he was a fabricator and made these little things that raised the motor up. Yep, they don't help us at all. But okay, so the motor mount is real shallow here. I have a couple of the plates that are longer, so they should bolt right up.
With the motor being so high, it kind of interferes with the hood. I wanted to do the Holley high ram and all that stuff on it, but I think we're just going with this setup for now.
I was looking for those bolts yesterday.
Found them.
I guess first thing I should do, get something to hold the trans up. The news about the new pan is that it's definitely way higher up, but if you notice, it can come a lot more forward than the other pan in the 55 could, just because the steering is tucked up compared. Recently, I've done a few things that have been making my life easier when I work on stuff, like just putting one bolt on each side and, you know, not trying to do all that. Anyways, now it makes my life pretty easy. So we're going to go ahead. I'm going to put some tension on the chain and then unbolt it and, yep, going to yank her out.
Well, I did the easy side off camera so you guys could watch me struggle with the hard side. Well, hopefully I don't struggle. We'll see.
Oh, man. Not gonna be that bad after all, I don't think.
And we're free.
So if you talk to yourself while you film, people watch it. But if you talk to yourself and there's no camera, then you're just crazy. I don't get it. Well, figured I was gonna be talking to myself anyways. She's out.
Funny story, when I put this thing together, I was like, you know, it'll be funny if we just kind of like leave it all greasy on the outside and, you know, put internals and studs and everything else on it and just run it like it's an old garbage motor, right? Well, I never took into consideration that every time I work on this freaking piece of crap, it's greasy as hell. I should have cleaned it.
Yeah, buddy. Old garbage ass. Alright, let's tighten this thing down. Remember that one time, probably about a minute ago for you, when I said, it's the same dipstick tube. It's not. Started out today thinking, I'll be done working by like 9 o'clock. Yep, I'm gonna just get started at about 9 o'clock.
Oh man, it's gonna be a hot one today.
Can't enjoy doing it if you don't do it 45 times in a row. Guessing you can just do a montage of ripping everything back apart again. Speed it up by 50,000.
I'll blow up into smithereens and spew my tiny symphony all up and down a city street while trying to put my mind at ease, like finishing this melody. This feels like a necessity, so this could be the death of me, or maybe just a better me. Now come in with the Tiffany's and take a shot of Hennessy. I know I'm not there mentally, but you could be the remedy, so let me play my violin for you.
Sometimes I wonder why I do things, and why I don't do things. Why the hell did I pull the pickup tube off this? Oh no. I still gotta get this one out. So we're getting ready to get real ghetto up in here. Oh. Well, hopefully the day's better than how it started, or I'm getting crushed. I'm gonna do it the safer way of the two instead of pulling that one and then coming over and doing this one. I'm just gonna pull the pan, take the tube off, put the motor back down, then come over, switch it out, throw this motor back in, take that dipstick, and you know the rest. Only reason I'm doing it the safe way, because if I get crushed and I can't get out from under the motor, it's going to get hot as hell, and I don't want to get dehydrated.
Yeah.
That's a damn rookie mistake, you ask me.
This is the lesson for today. Just make sure it's right the first time, huh? Another 45 seconds the first time, and I'd be done right now.
Yep.
It's literally like a quarter of an inch shorter. What the hell? Well, you live and you learn, man. You live and you learn. All right, pan one and pickup tube one is done. This will get shoved back in there. On to that one.
Well, it turns out that it's also hitting this.
We're gonna have to cut it.
Woke up this morning going, it's gonna be an easy day.
I lied to myself.
It's not gonna be that bad. All you gotta do is just swap one oil pan. Dump that thing in there, you're done. You're good to go. Lies. It's just one little oil pan. How hard can it be?
I'll tell you how hard. Hard enough. Well, I suppose I need to get some brake clean and clean that thing off. We're sprayed off and we got literally one more chance. That's it. That's all this thing gets. If this thing don't go on, I'm calling it a day. Everyone's always like, Leon, why don't you film more stuff? Like, well, I don't know. You want to see the same thing over and over and over again?
I don't,
but I'll film it if you want to see it. Yeah, one turbo should be enough. We're getting close. Scrub that AN fitting all the way down. Good thing I put a cap on it. And I don't need it. We got both sides over the mounts. And this side I have a dowel pin, just the tip going in. So I'm gonna go down just a little more, try to get the other side to pop in, and go from there. I got the two of them lined up and I let down the jack, and man, it is glorious. It lines up freaking awesome. Dropped right in. Now we gotta make sure this side didn't pop out. Pretty sure it's good though.
Yeah, I think we're ready to start putting some bolts up in this.
Well, I got both sides in. Oh man, I was gonna try to cheat and use a ratchet wrench. Ha, joke's on me. Yep, one little turn at a time. Could go get a ratchet, I guess, but that's okay. Almost there. Got one bolt on this side. So before, now we're right about where we were. This was just touching. Yes. I thought we were just getting the oil pan done today. I didn't think that the motor was getting bolted in. Oh yeah. Sucker. We got the bolts in. We got the dang gum steering done. Whoo, man, we are killing it. And we got that thing back together. Well, we got the engine back in it. I think it might be lunchtime. Oh. Well, there's an engine in each of the cars, and I'm thinking that's a pretty good stopping point. I'm tired now, but everything fits pretty good. I actually tapped the firewall a little bit on the corners where the engine was hitting, so now it's actually back a little bit further. This thing's in. All I have to do is put some nuts on the motor mounts, and I think I'm gonna start to do the wiring. But not today, man. It's hot. I'm sweating. Any of them that you like to see in particular, let me know. I mean, they're all pretty much the same build. Big old tires in the back and skinny tires in the front. See y'all next time, and have a great day.